never really found anything that I liked enough to permanently tattoo on myself. And so now that I'm going for tattoos, I think in the moments that I did picture myself getting tattoos, this is not what, this is really not what I had in mind. But I like it. I felt something kind of just south of my collarbone. It just felt like a growth of some sort. And 24 hours later, I was in front of a breast specialist who told me I had cancer. I remember that night getting into bed and I just howled and I begged to live long enough to see my daughter born. And Kel was 7 months pregnant at the time, and I just howled saying I just want to meet her. And you know, I had no experience with breast cancer. I have no family history. And you can't ever forget that feeling of, I'm going to die. And it occurred to me that if that happens, my daughter will have no memory of me. I started writing her letters so that I knew that she might not remember me, but I can still have influence over her. I can still be in her life. When I walked out of radiation oncology for the last time, I didn't feel any elation. I didn't feel any sense of achievement. We tried doing things to signify the end that was like, it's over, you know. Nothing worked. I was just so miserable. I also realised that I could change it. The type of reconstruction I had involved the transplanting of my stomach muscle and tissue and all of the skin up to the chest area. And on my right hand side, I would have a reconstructed breast, and on my left hand side, I would have my nipple removed and all of the tissue removed, and it would be rebuilt using stomach tissue.
It puts the breast back where it belongs. We don't obsess about our breasts every minute of the day.
And once I'd gotten through the initial reconstruction and the conversations came up about my nipples, I was explained that they're physically made using grafts. I quite liked how I used to look. I quite enjoyed my physicality. Probably say that it was my favourite part of me before all this happened. And I just wanted them to kind of resemble what they used to be. Today I get the colour tattooed on my nipples. Oh, I've joked about, you know, doves and scrolls and mum and all of those things, you know. There's so much material involved in, you know, with your breasts anyway. Even when I had my mastectomy, I would really try, particularly with the family. God, you gotta laugh, you know, running out of the shower, you know. My God, was it gone? I guess today for me is about ticking off the final thing on the list. I want the list ticked and put in the bin. When I made the call to this lady, she told me about all these things I had never thought about. She spoke to me about colour and about pigment and... But she was asking me if I liked pink or brown or how dark. And I guess because she doesn't know what they used to look like, then I've got to try and think and I've got to kind of pick the colour.
What's it called, Cass?
Girls' Night Out. And she said, oh, you've had breast cancer. And I said, yeah, I had a mastectomy. And she said, oh, I've had that.
And this is the colour.
And she pulled her top up and showed me her breasts.
Mine were based on.
Okay.
So this has faded down over time.
She says that it could, like any tattoo, it can fade, but I don't know how quickly that fades. It seems surreal that I'll have to get my nipples touched up every couple of years. Something else to add into the calendar. How do you somehow reconcile the fact that you thought you were going to die, but then you didn't? You're desperately trying to, forget what happened, but you can't. You can't ever forget.
What do you think?
Does it look like a girl's night out?
As long as you're happy.
It made me look back and go, I can't believe all this stuff. I can't believe. Throughout, you know, even through my reconstructive process, I dealt with it the same way that I did my treatment. Just head down, just get on with it. Don't think about it, just head down. They're just tasks. I'm being told I've just got to do things, or I've made choices that have resulted in these tasks that need to be done, so I just do them. But when I kind of saw the finish line, I guess it just made me stop and go, maybe it's over. My nipples won't work. They don't function. They won't function. They never will. But I don't care. They look real. They feel real. They give me the ability back to look in the mirror and to like what I see again. And I don't care that they're artificial foundations. They're my foundations.